where you are not probably is more important than where you are. My dear sisters and brothers, where you are not may be more important than where you are. In other words, who you are not goes on to define who you are and who you become. Something that I'd like to call the process of elimination. Each morning as I wake up, I know I do so with a handful of things. I'm talking about my identity, who I am, and who I am called to become. I'm the beloved of God. I'm the pastor of a flourishing church. I have family and friends that I need to commune with and stay in touch with. There is my health, physical, mental, and spiritual. And finally, there is the learner, the seeker in me that wants to learn and grow. And so, as I wake up each morning with this, what I call, handful of stuff, I go back to them time and again to see where I am. Because if I want to become these, then I need to eliminate in me, from me, all that I am not. Process of elimination. And so as I go through my routine day after day, there comes a time when I pause and ask myself where I am in each of these things that identify who I am and what I am called to be. Process of elimination. And I always ask myself where I am, whether I am in the debit or in the credit, whether I am in the red or in the black, whether I'm doing well or I should better wake up and start doing well. And so, what keeps me from becoming all this is when I go on to become what I'm not. For example, if I realize that I'm not behaving as the beloved of God, maybe I'm spending too much of time with the screen, in front of the TV, listening to the news, then I tell myself that it's time that I go back to my meditation stool, that I sit in prayer, in reflection, in meditation, in spiritual reading, in whatever that takes me and draws me closer to God, so that I continue to become the beloved of God. And I grow closer and closer to Him. Now, with that bit of introduction, we go to the gospel of the day. There is Jesus in the synagogue performing exorcism, expelling the demon. You know, Bishop Fulton Sheen once spoke of the expulsive power of Christ. When you strike a match, darkness is dispelled. When Christ moves into your life, all that is not Christ, all that is not godly is dispelled, dissolves, and just disintegrates and disappears. Process of elimination. God, who made the whole world for us, made us for Himself. And how disappointed He is when He comes and finds that our heart is filled with anything but God, anything but Him. And what does He do? If we invite Him and welcome Him into our hearts, into our homes, to be within our circle, He dispels all that is not godly, all that doesn't allow us to be godlike, all that takes away from our identity. To conclude, Michelangelo was being admired by one of his friends who said in glowing terms how great a sculptor he was and how he alone could sculpture such beautiful works of arts that become immortal. And Michelangelo seemed surprised and said, look at that marble. The angel is already there within that marble. The sculpture is already complete within that marble. Even before I begin my work, all I need to do is to chip away, to chisel away, to eliminate all that is not angel within that marble, and eventually the angel is released. My dear sisters and brothers, it's about time that you and I worked on this process of elimination on ourselves. And allow the Lord to do that work, to chip away, to chisel away, to eliminate all that is not godly, all that is not us. Because where we are not is more important than where we are. Because when we eliminate all that is within us that is not us, that's when we become who we are called to become. Let's allow the Lord to chisel away at us all that is not godly.